Hello everyone, this is Zahra from Kasawo S S Paper. I'm going to do number 4 of paper 2, which is of a continuous random variable. X has a probability function, this one. And part A says sketch f of x and please find a constant k. Then with sketching, I'm going to get the limits, substitute each limit in the function given. I have got three functions. And I'm going to start with the first function by substituting in the limit given. And our first function is f of x is equal to k into x plus 2, with the limit being negative 1 and 0. Then, when x is equal to negative 1, our f of negative 1 will be k into negative 1 plus 2. Then I'll have to get k. Then our coordinate will be negative 1 and k. Then I also have to substitute in the next interval, which is 0. When x is equal to 0, our f of 0 will be k into 0 plus 2. This is 2 times k, which is 2k, and our coordinates will be 0 and 2k. Then, after working out the first function, I'll have to go to the second function. But our second function is f of x equals to 2k. But this is a constant. When I substitute in 0 in the function, f of 0, we shall get 2k. Then our coordinates will be 0 and 2k. Then, for the next interval, which is 1, when I substitute it here, remember it is a constant, still I have to get 2k. Our f of 1 will still remain 2k. And I get 1 and 2k. Then, after the second function, we are going to the third function, which is f of x equals to k into 5 minus x over 2. With our limit being 1, x between 1 and 3. Then, when x is equal to 1, our f of 1 will be k into 5 minus 1 over 2. This is 4 by 2, which is 2k, and our coordinates will be 1 and 2k. Then for the last interval, which is 3, I'll show when x is equal to 3, our f of x will be k into 5 minus 3 over 2, which is a 2 divided by 2. I get k. Our coordinates being 3 and k. Then after getting our coordinates, I'll have to sketch, because they have told us to sketch f of x. When we come to our sketch of f of x, we're going to start with the first function. And our first function was k into x plus 2. And our first coordinate being negative 1 and k. Negative 1, k, lines here. Then followed by 0, 2k. 0, 2k is here, and it is having a positive gradient. So we're doing this and name it as f of x equaling to k into x plus 2. Then after that, we'll go to our second function, which had a constant of f of x being equal to 2k, and our first function was 0, 2k, followed by 1, 2k. And 1, 2k is here. It was a constant, so we're having the line. Name it as f of x equals to 2k. Then followed by the third function, which is k into 5 minus x divided by 2. And our first coordinate was 1 and 2k, followed by 3k. 3 is here, then on f of x we are having k, which is here. And this function is having a negative graduate. So when I'm to join, it will be like this. And name it as f of x equals to k into pi minus x divided by 2. But you cannot leave the graph hanging, so you join with a dotted line. Under curve is equal to 1. Our first figure we are having is the trapezium, and the area of the trapezium is a half of a into a plus b. We are having a rectangle, which is length times width, and a trapezium, which is a half of a into a plus b. Then for the first trapezium, which is a half, our height is, we are having negative 1, but with distance we don't have negative distance, which is 1. Then A is the shortest height, the shortest distance, which is from here to here. Then B is from here to here. That means we are having k plus 2k. Then with the rectangle, we are having the length as 2k times the width, which is 1, plus the second trapezium, which is a half times the distance is 3 minus 1, which is 2, into k plus 2 k. Then I equate to 1. Then here I'm having 3 k over 2 plus 2 k times 1, which is 2 k, plus 3k, this is 1, I get 3k equal to 1. Can multiply through by 2. Here I'm having 3k plus 4k plus 6k is equal to 2. 10 and 3 are having 13k, which is equal to 2. Then our k is 2 over 13. That is the value of the constant. Thank you everybody for listening.
Well, this is Mulega from Kasawo S S, and I'm going to proceed from where my friend has ended. I'm going to proceed with part B of number 4. It is telling me to find the median. My friend has already got the median, the constant, as 2 over 13. And with median, when you are having many functions, we first determine where the median lies by integrating that function. So I'm going to first integrate that function. And I see whether the median lies in that interval. Let's start. It is integrating. We already have our k as 2 over 13. We are integrating 2 over 13 x plus 2 with respect to x from negative 1 to 0. I pull out the constant such that I'm having 2 over 13. Let me write it. 2 over 13 integral from negative 1 to 0 of x plus 2. X plus 2 dx. So when I integrate, it is x squared over 2 plus 2x from negative 1 to 0. I now substitute in. It is 2 over 13. I substitute in the upper limit first. 0 squared over 2 plus 2 times 0, put in brackets, then I substitute in the lower limit, is minus 1 squared over 2 plus 2 times negative 1. Mm-hmm. 2 over 13 into 0. 0 minus. Minus a half. Minus 2. Mm-hmm. So, let me first calculate this. A half minus 2. It is negative 3 over 2. Such that it will be 2 over 13 into minus minus 3 over 2. Mm-hmm. This is a positive now. It will be 2 over 13 times 3 over 2. This 2 goes with this one, such that it will be 3 over 13. But we'll look at this one. It is less than a half. It is less than a half. Which means median does not lie in that interval. So it must lie, it must now lie in the second function. So let us start up. It will be now 3 over 13 plus integral. We are integrating the second function, 2k with respect to x from 0 to 1, equally from 0 to median, because we are trying to take median, equally to a half. Mm-hmm. It will now be 3 over 13 plus integral, I pull out k, but you already know the k, it is 2 over 13. So it will be 2 over 13, I also pull out the 2, so it will be 4. It will be 4 over 13 integral of 1 with respect to x from 0 to 1, equaling to a half. Equaling from 0 to m. Sorry, from 0 to m. 3 over 13 plus 4 over 13 into, I am integrating now. It will be x from 0 to m equaling to a half. And I now substitute in there. But let me first take this one, this side, such that it will be 4 over 13 into x from 0 to m equaling to a half minus 3 over 13. 3 over 13 a half minus 3 over 13. It is 7 over 26. Such that will be 4 over 13 x from 0 to m equaling to 7 over 26. So I'm now going to substitute these limits. Such that will be 4 over 13 into n minus 0 equaling to 7 over 26. 7 over 26. So this will remain as 10 to be 4 over 13 of m equaling to 7 over 26. Equaling to 7 over 26. So we are going to apply our algebra here. So it will be 4 m equaling to 7 times 13 over 26. This 13 comes this side. Mm-hmm. So now this 7 times 13 divided by 26. Which is this is equal. 7 over 2. 4m equal to 7 over 2. I divide both sides by 4. M will be equal to 7 over 2 times 1 over 4. So our M will be equal to 7 over 8. And that is our median. Correct? Okay.
With part C of number 4, and it tells me to find the probability of x between a half and 2. We've already got our constant as 2 over 3, I've substituted it here. Then, the probability they want is between a half which is 0.5. That means 0.5 lies in this interval of x between 0 and 1. Then, x between a half and 2. Then 2 lies in this next interval between x between 1 and 3. That means I'll have to first integrate this function from 0.5, which is a half, to 1. Then I'll also integrate a second function from 1 to 2. I'll start with the first function, which is 4 over 13. 4 over 13 dx. With the limit, our lower limit is a half. Then the upper limit of this function is 1. Then I add from 1, the upper limit is 2. But of this third function, which is 2 over 26, into 5 minus x, dx. Then with integration, I'm going to first pull out the constants, which is 4 over 13, integral from 1 half to 1 dx, then plus 2 over 26, integral of 5 minus x dx, from 1 to 2. Then 4 over 13, here the integral is x from a half to 1, then plus 2 over 26 into the integral of a constant is that constant I use the x, which is 5x minus x squared over 2 from 1 to 2. Then after integrating, you have to substitute the limit, the upper limit, then minus the substitute of the lower limit, which is 4 over 13 into x, substituting 1 in x, it is 1 minus a half, then plus 2 over 26 into, I have to substitute the 2, which is 5 into 2, minus 2 squared over 2, put a bracket, then minus 5 into 1, minus 1 squared divided by 2. Then here, I'll get 4 over 13 into 1 minus a half, which is a half, then plus 2 over 26 into this 5 times 2 is 10, then minus 2 squared is 4 divided by 2, which is 4, 4 divided by 2, which is 2, again minus this 5 times 1, which is 5 minus a half, because 1 squared is 1, 5 minus a half, which is 9 over 2. Then this 4 over 13 times a half will be 7, 6, then plus the 10 minus 2 is 8, then 8 minus 9 over 2 will be 7 over 2. Then the 7 over 2 times the 2 over 26. I'll get 7 over 26. This is 11 over 26. This is the answer of the probability. Thank you, everyone. Next time.